Hello, my name's Russell Hill and I'm the editor of Trout Fisherman magazine. And today, myself and some of my angling pals have got the privilege of fishing the world's only stillwater salmon fishery. That's Palm Springs near Rutland Water. Now let me tell you, there's some pretty big fish in here. You might get a 10 pounder, a 15 pounder, a 30 pounder, or perhaps a 40 pounder. There's some pretty big fish. Anyway, we've tackled up, we're ready to go. Let's see what we can pull out of here. Ben, why a salmon fishery right here in the East Midlands when people go up to Scotland and places like that to fish for salmon?
People can just come here with a single-handed rod, just their trout gear, and catch a salmon without having to drive hundreds of miles and get loads of new tackle and for just a trout angler to come and catch a salmon, you know, it's something you can do, really.
Mm-hmm. And do you think there's some people would disapprove of
I know they do, yes. It's because it's unnatural, but I mean, a salmon is like a trout. I mean, there are landlocked salmon, and they can adapt. They're very adaptable. I have to give them the correct conditions for them to grow, and to get them to grow to a great size, you have to give them what they want. So I don't think that they're in any way disadvantaged or it's cruel to them. I think they have a very good life, really. They're grown in recirculation, same as koi carp are, and they need specific conditions to flourish, which is why you can't just grow them in a river or on a spring, even spring water, you can't be done. So it isn't the same, really. Obviously, their normal cycle, they go to sea, so you really have to try and reproduce a bit of that.
Now, I know you used to supply a lot of your fish to other fisheries, Hazel Copse was it, and Ringstead?
Yes, Ellerdine.
Yeah. So what made you want to stop doing that and put them all in here?
I needed to make a living, and we saw that the salmon were successful in other people's lakes, so it's just a natural outlet for the fish that I was growing.
So tell me about this fishery at the moment. How deep is it here?
It's about 15 feet. It's spring fed, it turns the water over every few weeks.
Yeah.
And we keep it very clean, lots of maintenance. The water quality has to be very good for salmon, obviously.
Yes, yeah.
I have oxygen meters and all sorts of things to make sure the conditions are just right.
Mm. And where do the salmon mostly lie in here?
Deep down.
Deep down?
Yes, definitely deep down.
So you have a sinking line or an intermediate with a...
Intermediate with a weighted fly or sinking line, yes. Vary the retrieve and fish the hang at the end of the retrieve, really.
Yeah. I notice a lot of fish are coming close in. They do tend to follow the flies in, don't they? So just hang it there and give it time. Don't lift off too fast.
That's right, just like this. Yeah, just wait till you can make sure there's no fish following the fly before you cast again.
You've just started stocking with some very, very big salmon indeed. What made you want to do that?
Every angler loves to catch a big fish, really. And I like big fish. They hold a fascination. And of course the fight is so much better with a big salmon. It's just something that everybody dreams of doing, really.
And what's the best, biggest salmon that come out of this fishery so far?
34
pounds.
Last spring, yes.
You've got them in here a little bit bigger than that now. Well, we've had one fish out so far today, probably about seven or 8 pounds. What's the smallest in here?
Three or four pounds they go down to. I think the anglers like to have a spread of fish, but the average we've stocked this year has been about 16 pounds, so there are a good few big fish in here now.
Yeah. So that's a bigger average than last year, isn't it?
Oh yes. It takes me a long time to grow the fish, and 4 years really for a whopping salmon. So we've only been going for 2 years, so you know it takes a time to actually grow the fish.
Okay, who caught the biggest fish here?
It chap called John Headley.
John Headley?
Yes. In fact, his friend caught a 29 as well. They seem to be gifted, those anglers. But I mean, we've had a lot of upper 20s out too, and a good number of 20s.
We had comments about the quality of being very good. You obviously take a pride in creating a nice, lean, full fin salmon.
Yes, it's all to do with stocking densities, really, and low handling, and just looking after them, really. Tender, loving care brings the result.